Welcome back, ladies, gentlemen, beautiful people.
Dogs.
Not so nice people.
Relatives.
Dogs, relatives,
of
cats.
Of you people, yep.
Goldfish. Oh, you can never forget the goldfish.
We're about to jump into game five.
Oh, yeah, we are.
By
game
the way.
Five, because we awesome.
Yep.
Trending worldwide on Twitter as well.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's pretty awesome. You know, we made it happen. Yeah. We brought the boom to the MLG 5K today.
We brought
today.
The thunder.
We did. Yeah.
Yeah.
We did. We've already given away four awesome things. We gave away a cap, t-shirt, a hoodie, and an MLG scarf.
But now we're going to give away those four awesome things as one giant.
What?
Think of it like when the Power Rangers made the Megazord and then they gave it away. But
bam.
They never gave it away. But we're going to give it away.
Yeah, we're giving it away.
Okay, we can put it
back. Okay, cool. All right, the game. Okay.
It's Elevate Stunner.
People spawn in, please.
We might as well tell you the teams. Elevate
Stunner.
That's
a good point. That would help.
Yeah. This is map number five, so it has gone the distance, I believe. The last map was Capture the Flag that I think Stunner had won. So I don't know if they played any rounds. I saw on Twitter, I think Huke was asking for a reset because his teammates were lagging. So they might have played a round or two. We'll have to figure that out as it goes on. But we are going to be jumping right into this game.
We'll just assume. It's 0-0, so, you know, well, just fifth map, you know.
Yeah.
Bam! Boom! Winner of this plays Optic Gaming in the semi-final mat. And then, of course, from there, they will go on to play TR. Who would have thought that team makes it all the way through
I don't think anybody would have picked them
I mean,
start
like,
the day.
What?
But, you see, it's going to be TJ Haley. He's going to close that kill out right there, and it's going to be Stunner taking this first round, and they were able to get first blood right there, Ben. I believe it was Perplex was able to get it. So right there, big plays. SND is really going to come down to first bloods. I mean, it always kind of does, but especially on Advanced Warfare with the way that the movement is and how fast it is and the spots you can get to, that first blood, it changes the entire map and where you can push and go, and I think map positioning is huge.
So, let's have a look. I'm going to quickly...
Did I just see an LMG?
Killer?
There's somebody who had an LMG.
Miracle? No. Steady?
Yeah, they changed it.
No.
Then, yeah.
ASM1. What space are they running? He's running... Oh!
Whoa.
Huke! Oh! He just, like... Oh! I don't even want to talk about what just happened. Let's look at the other team. ASM1. Bao. And, well, he's dead, so... kind of doesn't matter. TJ Haley, though, on your screens... We'll see if he can try and pick up a couple of kills. And he just takes his time. Just chilling away. Nope, he's down. Perplexed. Last man up. 1-on-3 situation. And this is not looking good right now as he's trying to put some shots down. He's very, very tagged up. It's looking like this is going to be a tied up. Yep, it is. One round apiece.
Yeah, but you saw on your mini-map right there at the end that the players from Elevate were just all together. They were all circling around. No chance of, you know, somebody pulling off a crazy 3v1. You see all the players right here on your screen just pinching Perplex in the back area.
Yep, nicely played. I see a couple of people asking who won what in the chat, so I'm just going to go over onto my recently followed, and I'm going to go through. So, we started off the giveaways with, it was Charisma HD, no, sorry, I lie. Carlos Rodriguez. He won the t-shirt with an awesome picture.
Yep.
Tweeted at us. Then Charisma HD, he went out. Sorry, no. Carlos won the snapback.
Yep.
Yep. And then Charisma won a t-shirt. Then we had DVS Grunt, who won the hoodie. And just recently, Flares walked away with the scuff. But of course, you can still win the care package of absolutely everything. You have until the grand final begins to get those votes in.
Yeah, and you can vote as many times as you want. Somebody asked, you can change votes. We are not... holding you to your votes. You want to, be a front runner, pick whoever you want. That's perfectly okay with me and Ben.
Exactly. You can go crazy with them. You can tweet as many times as you like.
Yeah.
As well. That's the key. Better chance of winning that way. 1-1 in this game, though. Search and Destroy, Detroit, Miracles, and Killer. The duo going up against TJ Haley and Carnage Huke. TJ Haley, 3-1 right now. See what he's up to. Way, way, way out of that bomb site.
He has his full exo ability left, though, so that's one thing to note when you're just watching him move into this room right here. And I'm surprised he's going to pop it right there, and that's a smart play. He can see that they're... Oh, it looks like Miracle's going to try and get away, and he's taken out very quickly.
Oh,
TJ Haley pre-firing,
nice.
And that is an amazing kill right there on Killa. TJ Haley's going to get the bomb defuse, too. Oh, he's going to... Oh,
let him know, baby. Let him know.
Shoot those, sending
shoot those
a message.
Buddies. Shoot those buddies real quick.
The young base guy, TJ Haley. Taking out Killa and Mir right there in a 2v2 situation, but He told Hyuk, he's like, dude, chill, I got this. I'm going to do it alone. He took them out. That was a very nice play right there from TJ Haley.
It really was. The pre-fire as well was the key there to the success. Managed to pick up both kills, and the bomb, of course, gets defused. So 2-1 now. As we mentioned, the winner of this will be going up against Optic Gaming in the semifinals, and the winner of that is looking like they will, will play TR. There's no looking like they will be playing TR now in that grand final.
There wouldn't be any way they can get around it.
Yeah. That's kind of set in stone at this point. So you may want to start tweeting TR. Just saying. You know, these guys have beaten some big, big teams on their run. Of course, Optic Gaming looking pretty strong too. However, back to this game. In round number 4. Looking like, I just noticed, see how broadcaster says round 1?
Where?
Underneath the time.
Because it's only one round, I guess. It's what? Technically it's like one round and then they play the next round and then.
But we're at round number 4.
Yeah, I know. But it's
that made no sense.
Nah, you don't understand what I'm saying.
Oh, that would have been a nasty 2-piece. I have no idea what you're trying to say.
Yeah, I can explain it, but I get what you're trying to say. It says like one round. Like, it's not necessarily round 1, I think.
No, it says round 1. It doesn't say one round.
Right. I just think they did it backwards. I don't know why, but
What would the one round
mean? I get you.
Man, I'm so confused.
Don't worry about it.
Okay. I won't worry about it.
Drink some tea.
Okay. I could do with some tea. We were planning on getting coffee in the commercial break.
I know.
But then, sadly, Starbucks was closed. That's right. We're the Starbucks kind of guys.
Why wouldn't Starbucks be open at 10 p.m. on a Sunday?
Yeah, dude, I didn't realize it was so late.
Those people at Starbucks shouldn't have lives.
Right? I mean, their whole job is to serve coffee, right? That's the point. But anyway, 2-2. Yeah, all tied up with that play in that last round.
Yeah, interesting push right here you're going to see coming out of Elevate. It looks like they're just going to turtle a little bit in Garage, and they're going to have one player over at A. He's going to be in hospital middle map. And he's going to try and be roaming for kills, and it looks like they're going to push B. Little do they know, they have absolutely no defense they have to worry about at B. They can push in there right away, but they're taking their time.
Killer is just chilling right now. He has a player right next to us. Perplex just to his right-hand side. But Killer, he's just chilling, you know? There you go. There you go, Killer.
There you go, Killer.
Finally, you have a look. Again, someone using the laser sight on the ASM-1. Statistically speaking, doesn't really do anything to the weapon, but more placebo effect full plays. Bomb goes down at B as well. So now, 40 seconds left. See, a couple of kills going down. Nicely played from Killer. And TJ Halley, 1-on-4.
Yeah, not
I don't
spot.
Think so.
And I like that position from Killer. You know, once they were able to get the bomb down at B and he's on that A bomb site, he can watch across going into hospital. He can flank all the way around. He can even just look mid-map. Just great spots right there.
Yep, really, really heads-up play. Doing it from those boys. Obviously, the old Noble Impact team is now the new Elevate team. Name changes for the win. Just because there's a couple of guys confused in the chat right there.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, sorry, I had to cough.
Yeah.
I'm dying. You started me in a coughing fit. I blame you.
Yep. I take full responsibility for that.
Yep, good. I'm glad you do. 3-2 in this grand final. Elevate in the lead. Spacely cleans up TJ Halley. That's a big first blood as well because he's been playing very well. 5-4 now with that death. Study, he's going to pick up a kill too. So Perplex with that bomb is going to be able to get himself a kill. That was on Study.
Interesting push from TJ Halley. He was going to try and go right up the middle map and just look at hospital. But you see two players actually are going to go down for Elevate. It's going to be Study and Killer. So Hugh and Perplex is going to be in a 2-on-2 situation. They're going to get it down into something workable. And I know I like their chances. They have A pretty much on lock if they can get in there.
Yeah, the question is, who's going to win that gunfight? And it's going to be Hyuk. Picks up Miracles. That now leaves Spacely all by himself. Spacely just... Did he? No, he didn't. But he's dead now anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Tied up once again. 3-3.
Yeah, I like that play right there to challenge him as opposed to plant the bomb. Right. I think, you know, once you knew Spacely was right there around the corner, just, you know, forced the issue on him. And he wasn't moving. And I think we talked about this a lot during Columbus, but... In Advanced Warfare, you have such an advantage when you're the moving player as opposed to the player that's stationary.
So much.
If you are on the move, it definitely benefits you and helps you as opposed to just being the stationary player.
It really, really does. As now, we have a look. Go back to the attacking side. Elevate. As we said, tied up 3 rounds apiece. We got Spacely rocking Stim in Search and Destroy. That's something which I haven't seen used in S&D. I wonder how he's going to use that.
Yeah, that's interesting. I haven't seen anybody do that yet, and I don't know how beneficial it would. You see two players go down for Elevate right away, but how beneficial could Stim be in Search?
Casting in those two plays there. No, not gonna. Oh no! The assist. I thought he was gonna get the kill. That leaves Study all by himself. One on two. He needs to just get out of there. He's still using Dead Silence. Or XM Mute, I should say. But yeah, he finally falls. But yeah, going back to Stim and S&D. You know, normally you think, like, oh yeah, you use Stim before you go into a hard point, before the engagement, maybe after the engagement if you're one shot.
I mean,
S&D, I mean, planting the bomb.
That's what I was gonna say. Maybe plant the bomb, but.
But that's such a waste. Like, why would you not just go with Cloak?
Why don't just use Flak Jacket and use something and use something else?
There is that
your
too.
XL ability. I mean, you could have used Trophy. You could have used Cloak.
Yeah.
Mute.
Weird.
Overclock.
Very.
Stim is an odd XO ability for Search and Destroy. I think. Yeah.
Very strange. Now, TJ Halley, they're on the attacking side. Can we see this stunner team try and pick up this round? Of course, 4-3 in the lead now. 5-3 would be a huge boost for them as Overclock has been used. Now TJ Halley on the XO Mew. Man, should be able to get this bomb down. First blood's gone in favor of Huke though. Yeah, this is a big round now. If Stunner can potentially try and get this bomb down, it's halfway, three quarters. That is going to be bomb planted. And now pressure on Elevate. You got Study, Miracles, and Killer who need to make the play. Study is pretty much pinned in there. Surely he's not going to be allowed to come through.
Yeah, and TJ Haley's doing a great job. He's not over-challenging right here. He's just going to sit behind the bomb site, fire some shots, pre-fire a little
bit. Waste of time.
Yeah, and Study and I believe that's Kill over there. They don't know where to go. They have no option really but to push in. And there you see Study. He's going to push in, and they're just going to pinch him in the side. And they know one player outside coming in the front door, and that is Killa. It's going to be up to Killa one on three, and it's not going to work.
So, 5-3 now. Big plays coming in from this stunning team. I love that play from TJ Halley. Just waste some time. Pre-fire behind that bomb. Really force, you know, the guys at Elevate to make the mistake, and that's exactly what happened. Study was left with not enough time to really change. He couldn't rotate around the outside. He just had to push through and pray that he could win a gunfight, and unfortunately, he just couldn't do that. So now Elevate really on the back foot. Can't afford to lose another round here in Search and Destroy, and they're on the attacking side as well.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of strategy they pull out again on this attacking side. It looks like they're going to give up on trying to go B and go straight to A, but you see on your minimap, Stunner's going to push two guys into hospital, which could be pretty bad for this Elevate team.
And you see Space Lee peaks. Oh, wow, just melt with that ASM-1. And now there's Cloak. Better use of XO ability.
Yeah.
But not going to put the bomb. Actually stops as he gets tagged up. He recognized the nades were coming. He still has that Cloak. One more little bar of battery life, and he's going to go down from the side. 3v3. Miracles at the back is just going to have to watch as Killer gets shut down too. So now just down to Study and Miracles in a 2-on-3.
Well, Miracles is in a bad spot. He knows there's a player in hospital, and he knows there's a player in the left by A. He really has no opportunity to go anywhere. I think his best chance is to either push the guy hospital, or this player is just going to charge out of nowhere.
Reckless.
I don't know. Yeah, there was no reason for Vex to push right there. I mean, he could have easily have stayed where he was and forced that into a 3-on-1, but now gives Elevate a little bit signs of life with Miracles right here.
Yeah, Miracles can plant this bomb.
Yeah.
However he is, of course, by himself, Huke cleaned up Study, so 1-on-2. I like that play from Perplex and Huke, not making the same mistake.
Nope.
They're going to stick together. Ooh, however, Miracles is tagged up, and I don't think he necessarily realized where he was. Miracles goes to the charge, he's shut down, and that is going to be Stunner going through to the second semifinal of the day. They're going to meet up against Optic Gaming, who realistically the only big name team left in this now.
Stunner top 8, man. I was just a week behind.
Just a week off.
I was just a week off. Stunner top 8. But not just great plays right there. Looking like a completely different team with Huke. I think he adds, obviously, slaying power that they kind of desperately needed. I think they have good teamwork with each other. They've been playing with each other for a very long time that they just needed somebody to really pick it up in the slaying department and just give them those consistent kills. So big win right there against Elevate for them.
Big win. And as we said, that's going to be them progressing through into the semifinal, which means you have one more series to get those tweets coming in, to get those sort of applications for the giveaway, if you will. We have a hoodie, a t-shirt, a snapback, and an MLG scuff controller to be won. All you guys need to do is tweet your predictions of who's going to win this 5K. There's only three teams left now.
Right.
So, you know, it's narrowed it down a little bit, so that should help you all out. If you've already voted with another team maybe two hours ago,
vote again.
Don't matter. Vote again. Who's going to win the MLG 5K? All you have to do is put hashtag MLG 5K in the tweet. Tweet at UMG underscore Matt, at Benson underscore you, and at MLG with that prediction to be entered in for a chance to win pretty much every bit of swag that we have.
Right.
It's awesome. But for now, commercial break. When we return, the semifinal.